Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Nate Penda, and if you are tuned in today, it is my 1 year anniversary. Yeah! I am so excited, but also just like, I can't believe how far the year has gone. Yo, I was looking at my clips yesterday of my first video, and I was just like, this is so cringy. But I am here today to give you guys 12 things that I've learned in my first year being on YouTube, as well as I'll be including a giveaway. Now, if you're wondering, what's the giveaway, sis? I'll be giving away one Jackie Aina x Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. I did go ahead and I ordered two. So I ordered the first one when she put it on her Instagram, and I knew that that one was going to be the giveaway prize. And then I ordered a second one that includes the collectibles item or the collection itself, like the PR package that they sent out with it. But then Jackie Aina's team reached out to me and they let me know that she wanted me to receive the palette as a gift. So I am so honored and so excited. And because I don't need all three, I am going to give away one to you guys today in this video, and then I will be doing a review of the palette and I will give away another one in that video. So if you want to win the ABH x Jackie Aina palette, you gotta watch the video, because I'm just gonna throw it in there and you're gonna have to do what I say as far as what I tell you to write in the comments. It's gonna be a secret, so make sure you go ahead and keep on watching. Give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and without further ado, let's get into these lessons, sis. So the first thing that I learned after 1 year on YouTube is going to be, do not think about what the opinions of others will be. I feel like so many people are afraid to start channels, so many people are afraid to start Instagram, so many people are afraid to start TikToks or Twitter. So many people are afraid to just start. Whether it's something with social media, whether it's something in real life, people are so afraid, and I was one of those people. Before I even got started, I knew I wanted to do it for months and months, and I kept holding off, I kept putting it off, and that is one of my biggest regrets, because I have not had any negative, like anything negative connected with the fact that I started a page. So if I could go back, I would just tell myself, just do it. Don't worry about what others will say, because honestly, the saying that first people will ask you why, and then they will ask you how, is so true. So just do whatever it is that you want. So the second thing is going to be to do your research. Now, before I started my channel, I did tons of research. So I watched videos from other influencers, I watched videos from beauty gurus, I watched videos from people that are in tech, and all of those videos were to say, like, how do you start a YouTube channel? I wanted to know, what were the tools that I needed? What was some advice that people who were veterans would give or could give me? So I did a lot of research, and I'll be including all of the channels and some videos that I watched down below in the description bar, so that if you are interested in starting, you also have some resources. So the way that I looked at my research when it came to like starting YouTube is I looked at what all of the creators or what all of the tech people were saying that was similar. So what were some of the things that everyone was mentioning? And that gave me an idea of what I definitely needed to do when I started my own channel. And then the second thing that I did, I feel like a lot of us do here on YouTube, is I went and I looked at a lot of my favorite YouTubers, and I looked at their first videos, and then I looked at their most popular videos. I looked at the videos where you know, they were in the beginning, or where I noticed a change in the way that they created content. And the reason why I did that is because I wanted to see where they started. And that also gave me hope for myself of like, no one starts perfect. Everyone's first video is low-key cringy. And that's just the beauty of growing with them. That's the beauty of you guys being able to grow with me as well. So do your research. The third thing is probably the most important, and that is to invest in good lighting. So when I first started out, I only had a ring light, and right now I actually have a ring light and two soft boxes, and I'm actually going to get another ring light to light up the back and the side of me, just so that there's no more shadows in my videos, which I've started to notice. So lighting is super important. And when it comes to your videos, it can make it go from being super grainy to very clear. And a beautiful example of that, if you guys go ahead and look at the way the video looks in my apartment tour versus the way the video looks right now, the main difference was the lighting. And it's the same camera, same lens, the only difference is the lighting, but you see such a huge jump in the quality. The fourth thing that's kind of connected to like equipment is going to be to get a good camera. So cameras can be your iPhone, it can be a DSLR, it can be a camera that you buy from like Best Buy, but overall you want to get something where you can actually record. I started off with the Sony A5100. What I will say is that before you buy a camera, whether it's a Sony camera, whether you're using your phone or a DSLR, you need to make sure that you are going to use it. So if you want to test yourself and do your first few videos on your iPhone and then invest in a camera, I would definitely suggest that, because one of the biggest mistakes I made is I got the Sony A5100, then I realized I wanted the Canon 80D, then I realized I didn't like the lens in the Canon 80D, so I wanted to buy the body separate and then buy a separate lens. So I wasted a lot of money with returns and exchanges that I could have saved if I just would have done my research from the beginning and knew what camera I wanted from the jump. So I definitely say get a camera. You can use your iPhone, but if you invest in one, do your research first. And if you guys want a video where I tell you the pros and cons of different cameras that I've had, I can do that for you guys as well. For beginners, I would say do the Sony A5100 if you are starting out. But if you are predominantly a makeup channel, that camera is really not gonna be too good because it consistently overheats. So use your phone, honestly. Like, realty, use your phone. Fifth thing I learned is to respond to every single comment and build your community. If you are someone that has been on my channel consistently, you know there is not a comment that goes unanswered on any of my videos. It might take me a week, it might take me a few days, it might take me an hour to respond to all of the comments, but I am going to respond. And the reason why I'm going to respond is because if you took the time out to not only watch my video, but to type something to let me know a message, whether it's words of encouragement, whether it's your opinion, I am also going to take the time back to respond to you because I value what it is that you say. And by me doing that, I feel like I've built a beautiful community because I personally feel connected to my subscribers. I know, like, when I see certain comments, I know DZ, I know she's gonna leave a long comment. I know that she's gonna talk bullet by bullet based on everything that I said in my video because she is a super, super supporter and she likes to be thorough with her responses. I know that Allie is going to be one of my first people to comment and she's gonna put first usually if Kendra doesn't beat her to it. So I know my subscribers, I know what they like, I know what they want to see, but more importantly, I respond to them, we talk, they DM me, and she's Tiffany, we DM each other consistently. So I've built a community here with you guys, and the way that I've done that is by commenting back to everyone. So if you're starting out, if you're looking for things that you need to do, you need to respond to your comments. You are not a celebrity, okay? And unless you're getting thousands and thousands of thousands to the point where it's super hard, you should be responding to every single person that leaves you something in your comment section. So we're at the part where I'm gonna let you guys know what you can do to win the giveaway. So what I want you to comment in the comment section down below is what is your favorite video of mine and why? So what was the video that you saw that made you subscribe to my channel or that made you wanna come back for more? Let me know that in the comment section down below. You can just start off with my favorite video you did was, let me know, and from there I will be picking a winner. The sixth thing that I learned is that sticking to one niche is super important. For me, I know that I want to be known for beauty. And because of that, most of my videos are all about beauty. And I feel like the more that I get to know you guys, the more that we become personal with each other, I'll start to incorporate other videos. Eventually, I wanna start including some of my plus size hauls and some outfits that I do, or 3-in-1 get ready with me's. So I'm going to expand from my channel, but I started off first by being known for beauty videos because that is what I want my main niche to be. So I think that if you are someone starting off, focus on one thing first, and then once you have built up your community, you've built a relationship with them, and they like you for just you, you can go ahead and explore and add more things onto your channel. The seventh thing that I learned is to be yourself, or for me, to be myself. When I first started, I was so nervous because I am so New York, period. Like, I know I have a New York accent. I know that my voice is a little deep. We have some bass here. I know that I can be a little, you know, a little extra at times, but that's just me. And people that know me in real life know I'm always cracking jokes. I'm always just like being extra sometimes. Sometimes I'm very introverted. I'm very quiet. I'm to myself. But there's also times when I'm just like a lot, and I feel like I was a little nervous at first because a lot of beauty gurus, or a lot of people that I see on this platform, they're like very soft spoken. A lot of them are not from New York, so they don't have that kind of like roughness that I know that I have. And it made me feel like, do I need to change my voice? Do I need to speak a little bit lighter? Do I need to be careful of the slang that I use? And I feel like the moment I just like let go of all of my thoughts and I was just like, sis, and I just came here and I was just myself, is the moment that I really started to flourish, not just from like my content, but from me watching it back and being like, yeah, like if I wasn't me, I would watch this video. So definitely be yourself, because you're gonna attract other people like you. And like, honestly, I feel like people are diverse, and they like having diverse people to watch. So it doesn't matter who you are, what style you bring to the platform, be yourself. Number eight is going to be aware of products that are dropping or new things that are happening, trends, specifically within your niche. So for me right now, a lot of foundations are dropping. Next week is going to be literally every single day a foundation review, just because so many are coming out. I'm in the beauty space, and therefore I know what's up, I know what's new, I know what everyone wants to see and what reviews people want to see. And being that I'm someone of a deeper complexion, I know that there's other people that look like me that want to see how it looks on their skin tone. So you need to be aware of what products are coming out, you need to be aware of what tech is coming out, if there's any upgrades to anything, you need to be able to know that so that you can also inform your audience, especially if you have a niche. So if they know you for one thing, you need to keep them in the know, okay? The ninth thing I learned is something that I still struggle with, but it's to be as consistent as you possibly can. So I feel like with consistency just comes trust. And I was very open and honest with you guys and let you know why I wasn't as consistent. And honestly, for me, like going forward after I have cut out meat and fish, my energy has been better and I'm just feeling better as a person. I feel like consistency is something that I'm going to master. So if you are starting out, I would definitely say make sure that you're taking care of yourself so that you can be consistent when it comes to creating your content. But the more consistent you are, the more trust you build with your audience. They're going to know that you're either on a schedule or they're going to know that you consistently post, so they know they'll have something to entertain them. The 10th thing that I've learned is to think like a subscriber. I watch YouTube all day. Like, I don't even watch TV anymore. Literally, all I watch is either YouTube or I might watch something on Netflix or Hulu. But because I am a subscriber, because I watch a lot of videos, a lot of the times I think to myself, how would a subscriber think? So how do I think? What makes me like a certain person's video? What keeps me watching and not exiting out? What videos do I like to play within my apartment? And just like from there, from thinking of what I would want to see or what I like when I'm seeing something, I try to create those same things in my videos. So I know for me, one of the things that I really like is when someone has as much detail or description as possible. So I always try to include all of the description details in my description box. I also like when someone adds some of their personality to a video and they're just not flat. So I try not to be super flat and I try to add my own personality to things. So just think about what you like to see as a subscriber and try to bring those same qualities to your channel while also making it your own. And I feel like that tip is super important because it's like, if you're not enjoying the video that you put out, why would someone else? 11 is going to be don't worry about the numbers. Now, the reason why I say that is because for me, I've grown, in my opinion, so fast in such a short amount of time. Within a year, I've gotten almost 2,500 subscribers. And I feel like YouTube is a super, super hard platform to grow on just because there's so many people here. But I'm not really focused on the numbers. So even when I hit 2,000 or when I hit 2,100 or whatever the case may be, it wasn't something that I was just like, oh my God, now I hit 25 or now I have to hit 26. It feels good to hit those milestones. It feels good to hit 500. It feels good to hit 1,000. But I'm more so concerned with just like the quality of my subscribers. I want the people who are subscribed to me to actually watch and like my videos and engage with me. So it doesn't matter if I get 100 views. It doesn't matter if I get 60 views. It doesn't matter if I have 1,000 subscribers or if I have 100,000 subscribers. What's more important to me is that you guys enjoy being here. You guys are engaged with me and y'all like what I'm producing. So don't focus on much on the numbers, because if you focus more on your community and you focus more on building your community and just like bonding with the people that subscribe to you, your numbers are going to grow regardless, whether it takes a year or 10 years. And then the last thing that I learned after 1 year on YouTube is just to be honest. I feel like that's one of the things that I went into this platform knowing, is that no matter how good or bad something was, I was going to be honest. And the main reason is I spend so much money on makeup. Like, I spend so much money on makeup, so much money trying out products. And I know that whenever I see a review or I see a tutorial, someone tells me something is amazing and I get it and it doesn't work for me, or I get it and it was something that they left out, I just get a little frustrated because I'm like, dang, you said it was gonna work and it didn't. Now, that could be for a multitude of reasons. It could be because of my skin type, it could be because of my skin complexion, but there's certain things where I'm just like, you couldn't have missed this, because this is like, this is what everyone is saying. All of the reviews are saying the same thing when you go on the actual like Sephora website. So to me, no matter how a product is, no matter who comes out with the product, I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna be honest in a nice way. But I'm gonna tell y'all the truth, and I feel like you guys value that, and my subscribers value that, is that they know if I'm saying something, it is my honest truth, and I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. Honestly, doesn't only cover products, it also just covers you yourself as a person. Like, if there's something happening with you that you want your subscribers to know, if there's something affecting your filming schedule and you want them to know, you can just be honest, because again, you would have already built that community and trust with them. All right, guys, so we are at the end of the video, and I just want to say thank you to every single person that has subscribed to my channel. Thank you to to every single person that consistently comes back. Thank you to all of you guys for your kind comments, your messages, your DMs, your voting on my community poll. Just thank you for being here. Thank you for being you. Thank you for valuing what I bring into this space. Thank you for your advice. Like, honestly, I appreciate it so, so much. And I hope that we continue to grow. I hope that we continue to build our bond and that you guys continue to enjoy the videos that I put out. I love you guys so, so, so much. Yes, we hit a year. Bye, guys.